accomplishment.
The factory who got the help of the designer who participated last year in the fair, they showcased designs in last few fairs. They got good response for that.
Sir, how are you planning to sort of attract more designers into the sectors? Do we see companies also setting up own design houses?
The difference between not having a design product. So there's a factory A which makes products as per buyer specifications, and there is a factory B which innovates and presents their collection to the buyer. So these designers who came in, on the first designers were partially or fully employed by the exporters or domestic players. And they have seen the taste of this effect of innovation and design. And we have, as chairman said, so now having seen that taste, people are thinking, do I employ somebody on a temporary basis for 3 months or 1 month before the fair? Or do I employ on a long-term basis? Or I train my own local designers under foreign designers. So that it is a sustained long-term endeavor. It has already started happening. Big companies are already doing it. The medium scale will follow the path after these designers coming here. Because, you know, the report that I got after the first designers met, most of the designers were hired by exporters or domestic players. So they have visited factories for 4 weeks, or they have done a collection for them, sitting there. And so this will lead, this has sown the seed. So you'll see this gradually, you know, the whole momentum picking up and the belief that design and innovation can differentiate you. So that the whole thing is going to grow for me. Local designers in the first fair, and we have 5 local designers now. You'll be amazed, the most success was the 3 Indian designers. They, like I myself, didn't know that such designers existed until they got a platform. So thanks to CLE for creating that platform and exposing them to the full industry. So they were the most successful designers out of domestic. And you know, they've been continuously writing to me and asking that there should be a long term, and they really express their sincerity and thanks. That thanks to the first design affair, that most of the top exporters are now talking to them. Otherwise they said they were taking their bags, going there, but nobody would honor them. But now they've suddenly got a lot of respect and demands. So it's not only for foreign designers, it's also for domestic designers. The platform is excellent.
We got some support from the government, central government, organizing this program, but later on it's only on a commercial basis between the designer and the manufacturer. Any other questions?
Sir, you were saying about the numbers.
As you had seen that due to the European recessions, the overall export earlier were gone down by 9%, and now it has improved. And by the year, financial year, this ending this year would be about 3 to 4% minus compared to the peak period. And the US exports have gone up by 8.5%, and also export to Russia has gone up compared to the European business. So overall, the industry will improve in a couple of months. And by the end of this year, we'll have just about minus 3 to 4%. That's all I mentioned.
So the decline has stopped.
Sorry. Yeah, decline has definitely stopped, and we are seeing a great amount of.
Yeah, we are working on the new market. That's where we see the growth will come. Now, this month, in February, we are organizing 2 full-day programs in Delhi. One is for mainly focusing for the African market. We are inviting all the ambassadors from all the different African countries. Around 30 ambassadors has already been confirmed their participation. That's on 14th of Feb. So there's a big population in Africa. They're importing footwear, mainly the non-leather footwear from different parts of the world, but our share is very less, so we have to tap that market too. Second program we are organizing for the Russian market. Russia is a big country. They import a lot of footwear, but our share in that market is very negligible. So that too, we have a probably 22nd of February. 22nd of February, that program we have in Delhi, where we're inviting ambassador The Russian banks, the Russian custom people, so and see how, just to work out how we can have a better share in that market. So in this weekend, we will be working for the different countries too. You see, for any good thing, you may have to suffer a little bit in, on initial period. Demonetization is a very good thing for the country. It was definitely going to help the country on the long term. Initially, we had a little bit of problems for the wages payment and all these things. That's getting sorted out, and things have improved. We should thank our Prime Minister for taking this such a bold initiative, which is really going to help the country in long term. As I said, initially we had some problem because most of the raw material was being collected on a cash payment. Some of the workers, which are coming from the different parts of the country, were paid in a, on a cash basis. Wages were paid in cash because they don't have the bank accounts and all these things. So those things are getting organized. And now in the raw material also, the cash payments, the payment by check has been started done. So things are getting organized. So what, I mean, what problem we had a month before is now much lesser. And we expect that in time to come, things will be all right. And it's definitely going to help the country in the long term, that's for sure.
Point that initially, you know, the end of November there were a trouble, but actually in December, when you're talking to the retail market, even as a shoe locally supplied, they say the sales have been more than the last year December. So actually, the monetization in terms of retail into the shoe production has not been so much affected.